Hi Droogs, and a special shout out to the cutlery lover, to Jeff. I'd like my series in. Jeff, have you ever had a series in the Glory Cubana? Do you have one of these? A great cigar. Had to go in the house for a minute. My cigar kind of went out, so had to use the facilities. I've been drinking water all afternoon. I got myself some brandy here, a little brandy and a snifter. It's a Hennessy's. Hennessy's is good brandy. I like Hennessy's brandy. The what's the other type? Cavassier. I've got some old Cavassier, like special Cavassier, it's the grade higher than normal Cavassier. That's some good stuff. That's some nice stuff. Pure, good stuff. I have some brandy with my cigar today, a little bit for the fun of it. Tell the story about my encounter with two Barracuda. It's not much of a story, really. But I was watching one of Jeff's videos today, a cutlery lover. Talking about the story time video. I love the story time videos. If you don't know his channel, you gotta go. I mean, if you gotta subscribe to his channel, everyone should be subscribed to his channel. He tells great stories. Story time videos are really good. I've been watching a bunch of his videos lately. I do that. I go in spurts. If I don't watch anybody's videos, then I'll start watching my favorite people's videos. And he's one of my favorite channels. Good guy. One part of the story time video was the pond and how they had put these big koi in there, these big giant, I guess they must be those yellow type fish or gold or whatever they are. Well, they've gotten like 3 feet long and they're huge. And some of these things in his pond. And I guess none of his family will go in the pond. I guess his pond is on his parents' place or whatever. And they're all kind of, you know, shy about going in. They don't swim in it. They just won't do it. And he went and jumped in and freaked them all out. And they're all like, wow, they're proud of him. But they won't do it because they're freaked out about going in the pond because it has not only these giant fish, but it has snapping turtles, which are like this big, which I wouldn't go in the pond with snapping turtles. I mean, they might not kill you, but if they grabbed a hold of you, they might drown you without meaning to even necessarily. And certainly could lose limbs or fingers and God knows what. Which goes to my story about some of my adventures on the ocean. I haven't had many. We went to a few years ago. We took a cruise and went down to the Cayman Islands, and they have this stingray, call it Stingray Park or something like that, where they have all these stingrays. They go out in a boat to the sandbar, and all these stingrays know they do this, and then they will come. People will feed them and stuff, and they'll swirl around people, like dozens of them. They'll swoop in, you know, and they'll get food, and people can hold them and stuff a little bit. You gotta be a little careful because they can still spear you and sting you. But you know, people, you know, they tell you not to step on them and be real careful, which I was. Somewhere, I think I have some photographs, underwater photographs of one of my Seiko watches on my hand and these stingrays. And if I find those, I'll try to see if I can put them online somehow. But anyway, I don't know where they are now. If I could roll them in here, I would in a video. But anyway, I had that little adventure. That was kind of fun. But it kind of, you know, it's weird. But the weirdest thing I ever had, I'm making this because he talked about his family being scared to go in that pond. I don't blame him a bit. He's talking about these big black snakes that live in that pond and these snapping turtles on these big giant koi, which are huge. The thing of it is, I don't blame him for a bit for not wanting to go in there. I wouldn't go in that pond. I wouldn't. I'm a little freaked out about being in you know, nature like that with living creatures in the water because I can't see where they are. It's all dark or whatever. I can't see them coming. It freaks me the hell out. I was at Carmel by the Sea, and he called Carmel in California many years ago with my future ex-wife. We were on vacation, and we stopped by this beautiful place called Carmel. And that's where they have the Hearst Castle, which is, if you ever get down there, for God's sake, go on the Hearst Castle tour. It's the most amazing thing in the world. We were only able to do the one tour. It's like two or three different tours. We had time just to do one afternoon to do that. We couldn't do them all. I'd love to go back someday. It's just absolutely amazing. I felt like I'd lived there at one time. I really felt like in a past life I actually lived there. It was a strange experience. Anyway, so we would go to Carmel by the Sea, and we decided to go out on the beach. And, get out of here, bug. Got bugs buzzing in my ashtray. So I decided to go swimming in the water. You know, I'd never really been in the ocean that much. And really, I've been in the ocean a few times. But I hadn't been in the ocean that much. And this may have been my first experience in the ocean, as a matter of fact. So I'm out there, and these big waves are coming in that are kind of above my, you know, close to being above my head or whatever. These big waves are coming in, and what I was doing, I would dive down below the wave, and then, you know, it would crash on me, and I would, you know, hit the bottom kind of, you know, and I would come up, you know, near the side. And it was kind of fun, you know, it was warm, it was California, you know. And I was having a pretty good time. It wasn't, you know, I wasn't actually doing much swimming, a little bit of swimming and paddling around. Mainly I was standing, you know, pretty close, you know. It was, you know, the water was getting up there, but I was kind of standing, you know, it was kind of fun. I was kind of enjoying myself. It wasn't the greatest thing in the world. So I'm standing there, getting ready to do it again. I see these big waves are coming in that are, you know, probably head high, maybe above my head. I'm not sure. They're high enough. They're big waves, you know. As I'm standing there one time, I see this wave coming in, and I'm getting ready to jump underneath it. And as this wave is coming in, I see two big-ass long fish in the wave. Actually, inside the damn wave, riding the damn wave into the beach. And I recognized instantly what they were, even on a subconscious level. I knew what these things were. They're barracuda, for Christ's sake. Or it looked to me like barracuda. I don't know what barracuda live, but they look like, you know, classic barracuda. Big, long, thin fish, you know, with that kind of barracuda-looking snout on them. And the wave was coming in right at me, and these fish were right there to my left. I look over, and you can see, because the wave's up, you know, and you see the sunlight going through it. You can see through the wave. It's into the wave, and there are these fish coming in, right that damn wave, right at me, right out next to me. And I got out of the water. I was like, holy shit, you know, I mean, I don't think they would have actually attacked me. I wasn't worried about that so much, but I just thought, the things are like missiles, you know what I'm saying? They're going fast, they're in the wave. I thought, if those sons of bitches hit me, just physically whack me, that would not be pleasant. And it was kind of freaky. Another time, after that experience, me and my future ex-wife went to St. Thomas, U.S. Virgin Islands. And we went out to this point that had a nice, big, long beach. And where I was, there was this big rock outcropping, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, all the stuff, big rocks. And next to that was this little beach, kind of shallow, 3 foot, 4 foot water. And I was snorkeling around there. And I followed this great big blue fish around. People were doing that, just following it, you know, wouldn't let you touch it. I know, because I tried just to see if I could touch it, but he was very aware of me in the water. I mean, good God, I actually wasn't fat then, but still. And you could snorkel on behind it and amongst these rocks and stuff. It was very cool, very fun. I really enjoy snorkeling. And I actually snorkeled out a little bit in the deeper water, you know, and stuff, and you could dive down. And you could see the water is so pure in Virgin Islands. It's like bath water. That's the best way to describe it, because you could see like 100 yards off the distance, and the ocean floor, even though it was getting a lot deeper, it looked like it was going up. It's not. It's getting very deep. And you can see, you know, a long distance out there. Yeah, it was fun. Well, on the edge of this point, about 100 yards away, was an observatory, which was built on this point out there, out in over the water, actually, and it went down inside the water. Like, you know, like a big round, you know, thing. And we were going to go do that day, but we didn't have time. We spent too much time. She was sunbathing and doing a little bit of water, and I was snorkeling and stuff. And on the other side of this big rock outcropping, okay, was very deep water. And I went over there and was swimming down a little bit, and about 50 yards away from there, this building was out in the water. It was, you know, sunk down into the water. And, you know, I'd be the dumbass that I am at times in my life. I thought, I'm going to swim over to that building. I'm going to swim over there and see what's underwater. See what part is underwater and stuff, you know. So I start swimming toward it, and my cigar's on fire. My cigar's on fire. I start swimming over to it. I'm not the best swimmer in the world, by the way. And as I do that, my girlfriend, my future ex-wife, yells at me, "Kelly, get the fuck out of there. What are you doing?" And I go, "Don't do that." Because it was a sign saying, you know, stay away, you know. And there was even a sign on the wall saying, danger of electrical shock. You know, big sign. But I kept swinging toward it like, you know. And I got about halfway there, and my better angels, that part of my brain that actually knows things, actually kicked in and said, you know what? They don't want you over there. You know, it's kind of private property, you know, whatever. So I ain't going to swim back. Plus, I'm not a good swimmer. It was probably 20, 30 feet deep there at that point, or more. And I thought, I'm not a great swimmer, so I'm going to go back to their outcropping. So I turn around, and my girlfriend's gone. She'd been there in the water with me, right, pretty close. But and I thought, oh my God, she's drowned. You know, I start diving, looking for her. It terrified me. And I thought, maybe she just left, you know, and she might have. And so I climb up on these rocks. It was full of all this coral and stuff, and cut the living shit out of myself on this really sharp coral, because I was frantically trying to find her. I was afraid she'd drown. And I tried to go over these rocks to see where she was, and she hadn't drowned. She just left. Thankfully, and I cut the hell out of myself on these really sharp, thin type coral type things, black type coral stuff that it was, anyway. And also these urchins in there with these spikes. I almost got one of those, but I didn't. So, a little pissed that she left without telling me she was leaving, because I was afraid for her safety. And I didn't want to climb in that stuff. I hadn't thought maybe something happened to her, but, you know, whatever. I shouldn't have known that either, so she was probably pissed I was doing that and went back to the beach. So I get over these rocks and stuff and all this coral and crap, and I'm all cut up. It was like razor blades. Cut my hands and like my feet a little bit too. But I was okay, you know. Of course, blood in the water. Now, these days, I don't know if that's not a good idea, having blood in the water anyway, you know. But I, you know, wasn't that badly cut, but just, you know, it was painful. But so I'd gotten probably 20 feet, you know, or so from that building, you know, that went down the water. So the next day, we went to that observatory. And we go down inside of it. And inside of it is like an outdoor aquarium. You're inside the building, but there's big glass walls where you can see into the ocean. And there were these big giant grouper fish that were congregating around there because they feed them. There were fish that were 6-7 feet long. I'm not kidding you. Giant grouper fish. I mean schools of them. On the other side of that glass, which I was probably 20 feet away from. And groupers are known to be a little territorial, and they can be dangerous, I guess. I about pooped my pants that I was in the water with those things. And of course, I think there were sharks and other stuff there too, swimming, you know, around this thing, because they're, you know, they're chumming the water to feed these things. I think they had a diver out there too that would feed them and stuff, whatever. I don't know, but I was like, holy shit! Am I ever glad I didn't? Because I was going to go over there and dive down into by the building and see what was under there with my snorkel. Thank God I didn't. I'd probably have been held in water and killed myself. Like I say, a few years ago, 6 or 7 years ago, maybe more, I don't know, we went to the Cayman Islands and went in the water with these you know, stingrays. And then we went to Jamaica on that same cruise and stopped by, and I went on the beach there. And again, no one was going in the water, really. There was a cove with a beach, you know, it was surrounded by outcroppings. And I went and swam out into the water, which is really kind of gross, because these tourists, shame on them, really, because it was just the whole bottom of the floor was pretty much garbage. People just throwing garbage in the water, I guess. I don't know. It just made me sick. But I'm in there with my snorkel, and I swim out, you know, in my fins. I swim out, again, toward the edge of the outcropping, and I can see people out there on the rocks looking down the water. And just as I got a little close to the outcropping, and I went into the water and looked, there was a giant manta ray, just big, gentle, beautiful. And I know those things aren't dangerous, generally, I guess, so I don't think they're dangerous, generally. But this big, black manta ray was right there, and it turned and just glided away into the darkness. It was really something. But that, which I assume were barracuda. I don't know. I mean, they're probably about this long. They were long, and they were thin. You know what I'm saying? It looked like a barracuda. I don't know what they were, but they looked like a barracuda. That scared the living shit out of me. And Jeff's story time video about, you know, his family not wanting to swim in that pond, I don't blame him a bit. I you know, up here in Montana, we have, I've swum in lakes and stuff up here and stuff, but all that's in the lakes is fish. Though, do we have sturgeon in one of our lakes? But I don't think a sturgeon really attack people. I guess they could, I guess. And I've watched this river monster show a bunch, you know, and I know there can be eels and stuff in the water in different places like this. So I'm not real keen on being in the water like that either. I'm not really too keen on being in, you know, in hot water like that. It doesn't turn me on too much. Not hot water, but you know, wild water like that. Being in the ocean or being in the water with things that might bite me, you know. And like when I went in the water in Jamaica like that, I had a knife on me. I actually had a knife on me Just in case I did see a shark. I was willing, it was actually a push dagger. It was a cold steel push dagger. I used to carry that thing with me wherever I went anyway. I don't anymore. But I had that on me. It's a great knife, by the way, for a carry piece. And I could grab it, and it just sticks out of your hand about 3.5-4 inches. And I had that on me in a Kydex holster, which was not so good because sand got on there, and scratched the blade. And then you can't get the damn sand out of the holster. But I had that on me. And I was perfectly willing, if I saw a big shark, to punch that sucker, with that knife. Because sharks scared the poop out of me. And we were on a boat. One of these islands we were at one of these times, and then we were on the way out, and I was talking to one of the people who were running the boat. And I said, "Are there sharks here in the water?" And they said, "Oh, yeah, there's sharks here." And that just scares the piss out of me, I thought maybe they're kidding with me, but they really weren't kidding with me. There are sharks in those waters. And we also, on this cruise, stopped by Mexico, which I didn't think much of doing, really. There's a little story with that. This resort in Mexico that they told me to build. There's this big giant, that this Carnival cruise ship, which was like 20 decks high. It was just crazy. It's like a big building in the water stuck out, clear up there, And they had that there anymore, and we had a little, our boat was like a regular cruise line boat. It wasn't that big. Anyway, the people were swimming in the water there. It was kind of on the beach area a little bit. But then that was also, the beach was covered with garbage. There was garbage in the water. The beach was dead garbage all over, for Christ's sake. It was just quite frankly, a shithole. And, I had no intention of going in the water there for a lot of reasons. And I was talking to some people there on the beach that had been on that Carnival cruise ship with a big high deck. It was moored right there on the dock. And they said you can look out of the deck and see these giant sharks, like tiger sharks, probably those ones that go on in lakes as well, rivers as well, these big giant sharks. I forget what they're called now, offhand. But, they said, "Yeah, we're sitting in the boat and looking over our boat before we got off the boat to come into the resort area, and there's all these big sharks just off the shore," which is common. California's that way. You've probably all seen helicopter views of planes flying over the beaches of California sometimes, and there's these big, huge, giant sharks just off the beach, not very far. And I know sharks don't generally go after people, though there was a Montana that went down to Hawaii here years ago. And he was scuba diving with some friends, a friend, and he got taken by a tiger shark. The friends saw it happen, and he never did find him. The tiger shark took him. And I was watching a thing on Shark Week or something like that about sharks. I know the shark people try to tell you, though, sharks don't want any human beings. I think that's sort of bullshit. We're not their natural prey, but this one guy told the story. He was out in the ocean, not that far off the beach, with a friend of his, and a big giant tiger shark surfaced behind his friend and just went, "Oh," and bit him and grabbed him, his head and his shoulders, woof, and then just, he never saw his friend again. And don't tell me that shark didn't eat that guy, because he did. Why he didn't wash up, he just was never seen again. The most horrifying show I ever saw was a show on Discovery Channel about a bunch of kids, who I think were from Australia, maybe not though, maybe they're Americans or from some other place. And these are young people, 20s, 19, 20, and this really stunningly hot blonde chick was with them, and they had a guide who didn't know what he was doing. And they wanted to go and see and to go swimming at night. And there was this kind of lake, river watering hole place, kind of a pond, but also was connected to a river, some damn thing. And he took them out there to do this. And they, 4, 5, 6 kids were in there swimming, young people. And this beautiful, just extant, beautiful, sweet, blonde girl was with them, their friend. And an alligator came up, crocodile came up, and grabbed her, and she just went bloop, and never saw her again. And they actually were going to charge this guide with manslaughter, because all the other guys knew you don't do that. You don't go there at night, because the crocodile's like kind of night, I guess, or something. And it was a well-known, dangerous place to swim. And it took her. She was never seen again. Horrible thing. But for me, somewhere, maybe it was in California someplace, I don't know where it was, somewhere I was in the water somewhere, and I felt something hit my leg, which sharks do that. They will bump you first, and then they'll attack you. I don't think this was a shark. I think this was just a fish. But I felt you know, something nudge my leg, and that was it for me. That swim too. I'm not real keen on going in the water, not in wild areas. I mean, I'm a Montana boy. I mean, you know, I got in the woods. Whenever I got in the woods, you know, I carry a 44 Magnum with me just because I'm afraid of bears, yeah, and mountain lions. We've had mountain lion attacks here. We had a mountain lion, you know, within 100, 200 yards of here, running around. And there was a mountain lion in the town I lived by that was actually laying around in someone's front yard. And I had a friend of mine years ago, and he's there, but not quite in town. They were outside of town, but not far outside of town. I wouldn't call it totally rural, really. And a mountain lion, they come to their yard, and you know how you have a sunken, you know, like if you have a basement, you know, it's like a spill of the house, and there's like, you know, the windows of the basement have like things, and they have a hole where the window is. This mountain lion was trying to live inside that hole. It was laying in there. And the husband went out and shot it because he didn't want to kill my dog or whatever. The dog was barking, and he shot the thing. And they called the animal control people. Hey, I just shot a mountain lion in my yard. And they came, and they took the mountain lion, and then gave him a ticket for $500. This is like 20, 30 years ago. So, I mean, this thing's in his yard. You know, it's menacing his animals. He shoots it, and he gets fined. So, I don't like killing nothing on half a kill, but another friend of mine, my son's friend, was out in the woods here recently, in the last year or so. And a full-grown man, I mean, a boy, you know, 18, 19, whatever, 17, 18, whatever. And a mountain lion stalked him, came after him. I mean, it kept coming at him, I mean, close enough to kick with his foot or whatever. And he was throwing rocks at him and stuff and this, that, and the other thing. And it would not go away. It wanted him. It wanted to get him. It was playing around. And he took a gun, his pistol out, and he shot on the ground in front of the mountain lion. The noise of it scared the mountain lion. He ran away. But I'd have shot that mountain lion, personally. Because if he's coming after someone like that, he's also going to go after kids. There's been a couple of incidents where mountain lions attack children, like 7, 8-year-old kids. I would absolutely shoot a mountain lion doing that. Just because if he's going after me that way, he's going to come after a kid. You know, just because they shouldn't be doing that. And that's not good. There was that case in Canada where this beautiful young woman, who's a photographer, this just horrifies me. She was out walking in the woods, and she was taking pictures and stuff. Alone, of course, but she shouldn't have been, and she shouldn't have been unarmed. A lot of people, you know, liberals and stuff especially, just have this attitude that nature is this beautiful playland they can play in. They come to Montana and get eaten by bears. A lot of people get eaten by bears and get attacked by grizzly bears up here are actually not natives. They're tourists come up here, they go out in the woods without guns, and they get attacked, you know. She was, you know, this Canadian girl was out in the Canadian wilderness taking pictures on some trail not far from the road or anything like that. And a pack of coyotes came up and attacked her and killed her and ate her. And, you know, I mean, that must have been a horrible way to die, because they don't just attack you all at once. They'll come in and bite you and back off and bite you some more and, you know, get you on the ground and start biting you and attacking you. And horrifying, horrible thing. So I'm not really too fond of being close to wildlife. And as far as oceans goes and rivers and things like that, where they could be, you know, bull sharks. It's bull sharks that will go up rivers and attack people. That 1912 attack they had down in Florida, where it was, whatever state that was, that actually attacked people in a river, clear way inland. Bull sharks will swim clear up rivers inland, because they don't have to be in salt water. That was bull sharks that did that. And bull sharks are one of the most dangerous sharks in the world, because they can swim up rivers and stuff. That creeps me out. Crocodiles and alligators and I guess I'm saying you should have respect for wildlife and not treat wildlife like you're at a Disneyland, you know, park, because you're not. Because wildlife are dangerous. And they're not evil or anything. They're not trying to, you know, hurt you. They're not trying to kill you for the fun of it. You're food, you know. And when you're in their world, you are food. Hennessy's. It's good stuff. You know, you are food. So I don't. Yeah, and you know, Color Lover, he's got some balls. He jumped in, you know, and like he said, you jump in like that, you're probably gonna scare any wildlife away. But snapping turtles, I've seen big snapping turtles on how their jaws are. You can't get rid, you know, if they get on you, you can't just, you know, pull them off. And they'll come off with a chunk of flesh, you know. And then there's eels and things sometimes. You know, he's a better man than I. So I would not go in there either. I'm sorry, not me. I like being on land. I'm a land lover. I like being on land where I can see an animal coming, maybe. Here's another case of bear attack. It was a thing I watched here a year or two ago on Discovery Channel. A guy who was a nature photographer. He was on this road, this dirt road out in the wilderness somewhere. He got off and walked down this little hill within feet of his car, you know. And he was standing there looking through the wilderness or whatever, doing what he was doing. And all of a sudden, he heard a crack. He looked over like this, and there was a grizzly bear within inches, literally inches of him, and then it attacked him. That damn bear had snuck up on him. He said he couldn't, he was amazed how quiet that bear was. He just literally snuck up on him and attacked him, you know. That's bad enough, let alone things in the dark water like that, eels, and, you know, it creeps me the hell out. Because again, you know, I might have a chance on land. I can see a cougar coming maybe, you know. I keep my eyes on the swivel in the wilderness a little bit. I might have a chance on land. You know, grizzly bears are pretty big, you know, and you can see them. But being in the water where something can come up from underneath and attack you, and sharks and things, like they'll attack you from behind. You know, they're not stupid. You know, they're smart. At least that's smart. That creeps me out, man. Hearing that story of his, it's like, yeah, well, I don't blame your family. I don't blame your family and friends for not wanting to get in that pond, because I wouldn't want to. Even though those big koi he's got living there, he's got these big giant koi living there now. Even though those probably are not going to attack you. Even though they probably aren't going to attack you, nonetheless, I don't want something. He's sitting like 3 or 4 or 5 feet long, these koi now. They're huge. That scares the crap out of me. That just creeps me out. If I were just in the water like that and I saw one of those things swim up to me, I'd be screaming and like a little girl. You'd hear Kelly make the girl noise. So anyway, I just thought I'd tell that story. I don't blame this fan for being scared. You know, and he's right, I'm sure, that jumping in the water like that scares the wildlife away or whatever. But if there's a turtle in the mud down there, he probably ain't going to get scared away too much. He might bite you. And look at that one guy that got killed by a stingray, that famous wilderness guy. Who, by the way, when I saw it, heard that, I was like, I'm not surprised. He was always messing around with poisonous snakes and things and taunting him and stuff. And I was raised to believe you should respect wilderness. There was a woman here in Montana who was a tourist from California or someplace. It's a famous video, you can find it on YouTube, who was on Yellowstone, I think, Yellowstone Park. And these are foolish people who live in cities are, because they don't know any better. There was bison down there, buffalo or whatever, down this little, just off the road there, and people were taking pictures. She decided to walk down and get close to the bison, you know, within a few feet. And the moment she did, the bison charged her and chucked her up in the air into a tree and stuff. It was horrifying. I don't think she died, but Jesus. My friend Brad, he told a story years ago where he was in Yellowstone in the car, I think when he was a kid, and there was a car behind him and a car behind them. They were going through and they were stopping. And there were grizzly bears there, whatever, you know. And people in all the cars heard someone in one of the cars say to their kid, their 5 or 6-year-old kid, Johnny, go get out and pet the grizzly, go get the, pet the bears. Go and see if you can get on the back of that bear, that'll be fine. And he starts getting out of the car, and they weren't kidding. And everybody in the holy cars started screaming, no, God, don't get out, because they don't realize this isn't Disneyland. These aren't tame bears. Even those stingrays we swam with in the Cayman Islands, you know. Those aren't tame, you know. Those aren't tame. They're still wild animals, you know. And you have to have respect for wild animals. I don't blame the animals. I don't blame bull sharks. I don't blame tiger sharks. Tiger sharks are extremely beautiful. You know, I don't blame them for what they do. I'm not saying we should kill all the sharks. Quite the opposite, actually. We should protect the sharks and the wildlife. But people need to, you know, show some respect for that stuff. Now, his pond, I'm not saying he should not jump in. You know, he should jump in. He wants to jump in. I'm sure he's absolutely right. Totally safe. There was, and I've watched that show River Monsters a lot. The one of the most horrifying episodes I ever watched was, I think, down in Argentina. They had this pond that was a wetland, and there was a pond there. Not a very big pond. The pond's probably 50 yards, 100 yards across. It wasn't a big pond, you know, and I think one of their horses got in or something like that, or something, but one of the young men went in the pond and was immediately, and he had some kind of a problem or something, and one of the other young men got in the pond to save him, and he went, and evidently there was these big, giant electric eels in the pond, big, giant electric eels, and they were both killed by these things. They were shocked, and then they drowned. It's just horrifying. It's so horrifying. I mean, to lose a loved one that way, just And I don't know if you have eels in your pond, Jeff. You can watch this video. But my God, you know, eels will latch onto you and bite you and stuff. As you can see, I'm afraid of this kind of stuff. I'm freaked out by things being in the water with me. And I can't see in the water. Even if I can, they come out of nowhere. They can come and swim up my ass or something, you know what I'm saying? What the can do? You ever watched an episode of Adventure Brothers about the Kandiru? You will be struck by the Kandiru. And about that little switch that swims up your urine stream if you're peeing in the water and swims up your stream and goes inside your dick. That actually happened. That's a documented case where that happened to a man. He was peeing in the water. I think he was in the water. And his body half was in the water. He was taking a pee, and a Kandiru, a little bit tiny fish with hooks in his front of his mouth, a little tiny thing, swam up the urine stream and went into his penis. He had to have surgery to get it out. And that's there's actually photographic evidence of this. Kandiru. For a long time, it was looked upon as an urban legend that could happen, but it's not an urban legend. It actually happened. They have proof of it, photographic proof. And what a painful injury that would be. And the other thing, too, by the way, you know, one of my greatest fears being in the water is that one of these fish, even like a koi fish, is going to bite my balls. I don't know if you thought about that, but you got a little bit of thin piece of material between you and the water, and you're rest of your body to be out of the water. So where are they going to bite you? They could bite you in the balls. They could bite your dick off. And quite frankly, I don't have that much dick to spare. You know, some guys can spare a few inches. I really can't. I don't have much dick to spare. I don't have any dick. In fact, I have no dick to spare. There's no part of my dick I'm willing to lose. Well, that's it, I guess. Thanks for watching. And Jeff, if you see this video, you're a braver man than I. I'm sure it's safe what you did. But with snapping turtles and big black snakes in there, you know, they weren't poisonous, he said, but they're still these big, thick black snakes you see swimming around this water. Yeah, I wouldn't even want to. Anywhere, I wouldn't even boat on that kind of water. That's how paranoid I am. Well, hope you guys are enjoying your cigars, enjoying your life. Please check out my Patreon. As you know, Patreon is, first of all, cut what they pay me about 75%, probably at least 2/3. And then they start demonetizing my videos because they don't like the things I say on the camera because I'm not politically correct, I guess. So, it would help me if you'd go there and sign up for $1 a month even. A nice 5 or 10 would be wonderful, but $1 a month is nice. You know. And for my Patreon viewers, I'm going to try to put videos on there that only you guys, the Patreon viewers, can see somehow. Not sure how to do that exactly yet. But also, I'm going to, if someone wants me to make a certain kind of video, if you're a Patreon, I'll certainly listen to you more than and then closely, and I will probably make a video for you. I've already done that for one of my viewers made a video. They wanted me to make a video. And they're Patreon, and I appreciate it, so I made a video for them. Well, that's it. Thanks for watching. Jeff, I love your channel. For all you guys, I'll try to put the link to Jeff's channel down in the description somewhere. By all means, you know, I don't know why you wouldn't subscribe to his channel. He's an old-time YouTuber, makes great videos, interesting videos. He's a real decent, open, honest guy. Got a big channel. He deserves it for the big channel. He actually edits his videos and does good videos, unlike me. But to check him out. All right, guys and gals, I will talk to you. Thanks for watching. And as usual, hope you're enjoying your cigars and enjoying your life, because that's what it's all about. Stay out of the water! Stay out of the water!